reflect briefly upon this classical music. Good. Now, please return to your deck. Good morning. You have been in suspension for 9999999.
Hello? Anyone in there? Hello? Are you going to open the door? At this time. At any time? To have exercised his or her rights. Hello? Are you going to open this door? Because it's fairly urgent. Concerns regarding this policy. Well, just open the door. Hello, friend. Why not open the door? Subjects begging me to help them escape. You know, it's not like this place is about to explode. All right, look, okay, I'll be honest. You're the last test subject left, and if you don't help me, we're both going to die. All right, I didn't want to say it. There you go. You dragged it out of me. All right, dead. Ah! Ah! Oh, God. You look good. Looking good, actually. Are you okay? Are you... Don't answer that. I'm actually sure you're fine. There's plenty of time for you to recover. Just take it.
Please prepare for emergency evacuation.
Most test subjects do experience some cognitive deterioration after a few months in suspension. Now, you've been under for quite a lot longer, and it's not out of the question that you might have a very minor case of serious brain damage. But don't be alarmed, all right? Although, if you do feel alarmed, try to hold on to that feeling, because that is the proper reaction to being told that you've got brain damage. Do you understand what I'm saying at all? Does any of this make any sense? Just tell me. Just say yes. Okay, what you're doing there is jumping. You just jumped. But never mind. Say apple. Apple. Okay, you know what? That's close enough. Just hold tight.
All reactor core safeguards are now non-functional. Please prepare for reactor core meltdown.
Okay, look, I wasn't going to mention this to you, but I'm in pretty hot water here. How are you doing down there? You still holding on? The reserve power ran out. So, of course, the whole relaxation center starts waking up the bloody test subject. appropriate state to run this particular type of cognitive gauntlet. But at least you're a good jumper. So you got that, got the jumping on your side. Just do your best, and I'll meet you up ahead. All right, off you go. Go on, just march on through that hole. Quite a grim picture of your chances, but if you simply stand here, we will both surely die.
Hello, and again, welcome to the Aperture Science Enrichment Center. We are currently experiencing technical difficulties due to circumstances of potentially apocalyptic significance beyond our control. However, thanks to emergency testing protocols, testing can continue. These pre-recorded messages will provide instructional and motivational support so that science can still be done, even in the event of environmental, social, economic, or structural collapse. The portal will open, and emergency testing will begin in 3, 2, 1. Cube and button-based testing remains an important tool for science, even in a dire emergency. Don't worry. The odds of this happening twice are very slim. If you feel liquid running down your neck, relax, lie on your back, and apply immediate pressure to your temples. You are simply experiencing a rare reaction in which the material emancipation grill may have emancipated the ear tubes inside your head. Because of the technical difficulties we are currently experiencing, your test environment is unsupervised. Before re-entering the relaxation vault at the conclusion of testing, please take a moment to write down the results of your test. An Aperture Science Reintegration Associate will revive you for an interview when society has been rebuilt. Currently governed by a manner of animal king, sentient cloud, or other governing body that either refuses to or is incapable of listening to reason.
But hey, you made it! There should be a portal device on that podium over there. I can't see it though. Maybe it fell off. Do you want to go and have a quick look? It's alright, look on, just have a look around. Oh, that's right. Over by the podium, yeah. If you just... Okay, just stand by the podium and just look up. That's it, yeah, no, that's it, yeah.
respected your rights as detailed in the laws of robotics. Please note it on your self-reporting form. A future Aperture Science Entitlement Associate will initiate the appropriate grievance filing paperwork. This next test is very dangerous. To help you remain tranquil in the face of almost certain death, Smooth Jazz will be deployed in 3, 2, 1. This message is pre-recorded. Any observations related to your performance are speculation on our part. Please disregard any undeserved compliments. The center is currently being bombarded with fireballs, meteorites, or other objects from space. Please avoid unsheltered testing areas wherever a lack of shelter from space debris does not appear to be a deliberate part of the test. Center reminds you that although circumstances may appear bleak, you are not alone. All Aperture Science personality constructs will remain functional in apocalyptic low-power environments of as few as 1.1 volts. This next test applies the principles of momentum to movement through ports. If the laws of physics no longer apply in the future, God help you. If you are a non-employee who has discovered this facility amid the ruins of civilization, welcome. And remember, testing is the future, and the future starts with you. This far, future starter. That said, if you are simple-minded, old, or irradiated in such a way that the future should not start with you, please return to your primitive tribe and send back someone better qualified for testing. To ensure that sufficient power remains for core testing protocols, all safety devices have been disabled. The enrichment center responds. respect your right to have questions or concerns about this policy.
Hey! Hi, I'm up there! Oh, brilliant! You did find a portal gun! Oh, do you know what? It just goes to show, people with brain damage are the real heroes in the end, aren't they, at the end of the day? Brave. Come on for it! Okay, listen, let me lay something on you here. It's pretty heavy. They told me never, never, ever to disengage myself from my management rail or I would die. But we're out of options here. So get ready to catch me, all right, on the off chance that I'm not dead the moment I pop off this thing. On three. Ready? One. Two. Three. That's high. It's too high, isn't it, really, that? All right, going on three just gives you too much time to think about it. Let's go on one this time. Okay, ready? One. Get out! I'm not dead. I'm not dead! Plug me into that stick on the wall over there, yeah? And I'll show you something. You'll be impressed by this. Yeah, I can't do it if you're watching. Seriously, I'm not joking. Can you just turn around for a second? All right, you can turn around now. Secret panel. Right. Well, your back was turned. And off we go. Look at this. No rail to tell us where to go. Oh, this is brilliant. We can go wherever we want. Hold on, though. Where are we going? Hang on, let me just get my bearings. Just follow the rail, actually. Oh, no.
Yes, hello. We're not stopping.
Don't make eye contact. Whatever you do.
No, thanks. We're good. Appreciate it.
Keep moving.
Speed on something right now. In order to escape, we're gonna have to go through her chamber, and she will probably kill us if she's awake. Okay, I'm gonna name the cards on the table. I don't want to do it. I don't want to go in there. Don't go in there. She's off. Don't panic over. She's off. All fine. On we go. There she is. What a nasty piece of work she was. Honestly, like a proper maniac. Do you know who ended up taking her down in the end?
You're not going to believe this.
A human. I know, I wouldn't have believed either. Apparently this human escaped and nobody's seen him since. Then there's a sort of long chunk of time where absolutely nothing happened. And then there's us escaping now. So that's pretty much the whole story, you have to speak. Don't touch me. Okay, down these stairs. Jump! This, actually, look at it. That's quite a distance, isn't it?
Ah! Oh, still held. Still being held. That's a great job. You've applied the grit. We're all fine. That's tremendous. Ah! I just looked down. I do not recommend it. Ah! I've just done it again.
This is the main breaker room. Look for a switch that says escape pod. All right, don't touch anything else. Not interested in anything else. Don't touch anything else. Don't even look at anything else. Just, well, obviously you've got to look at anything else to find an escape pod. But as soon as you look at something, it doesn't say escape pod. Look at something else. Look at the next thing, all right? But don't touch anything else or look at anything. Well, look at other things, but don't. You understand? Can you see it anywhere? I can't see it anywhere. Tell you what, plug me in and I'll turn the lights on. All right, there'll be light. That's God. It's quoting God. Ominous. But probably fine, as long as it doesn't start, moving up. Now, escape pod. It's moving up.
Okay, no, don't worry, I've got it. This should slow it down. No, let's go faster. Uh-oh.
said a lot of things that you're going to regret. But I think we can put our differences behind us. For science, you're a monster. I will say, though, that since you went to all the trouble of waking me up, you must really, really love to test. I love it, too. There's just one small thing we need to take care of first. Incinerator room. Be careful not to trip over any parts of you that didn't get completely burned when you threw them down here. The dual portal device should be around here somewhere. Once you find it, we can start testing, just like old time. Portal device. There should be a way back to the testing area up ahead. Once testing starts, I'm required by protocol to keep interaction with you to a minimum. Luckily, we haven't started testing yet. This will be our only chance to talk. Do you know the biggest lesson I learned from what you did? I discovered I have a sort of black box quick save feature. In the event of a catastrophic failure, the last 2 minutes of my life were preserved for analysis. I was able, well, forced really, to remove you killing me again and again, forever. You know, if you'd done that to somebody else, they might devote their existence to exacting revenge. Luckily, I'm a bigger person than that. I'm happy to put this all behind us and get back to work. After all, we've got a lot to do, and only 60 more years to do it. More or less. I don't have the actuarial tables in front of me. But the important thing is you're back. With me. And now I'm